The Russian Air Force mostly uses strategic bombers that are remnants of Soviet design. Furthermore, Tupolev's design and manufacture are linked to the supremacy of Russian strategic bombers. Sukhoi, which is experienced in designing jet and fighter bombers, seemed to have taken a chance when it introduced the T-60's intermediate bomber. During the 1980s Soviet era, the Kremlin had created a successor to the Su-24 Fencer fighter bomber, first flight July 2, 1967, and the Tupolev Tu-22M Backfire strategic bomber, first flight August 30, 1969. The T-60S bomber, which the Sukhoi Design Bureau designed in 1984, is intended to be able to cruise at supersonic speeds. There is relatively little information known on the technical specifications of this bomber because it was part of a covert project during the Cold War. The swing wing of the T-60S is thought to feature changeable geometry, similar to that of the Tu-22 and Tu-160 Blackjack. Two engines with two-dimensional thrust vectoring nozzles are fitted on the T-60S. Up to 6 Ka-1-1 cruise missiles, AS-15 and AS-16 missiles, free-fall nuclear bombs, and precision-guided conventional munitions are among its armaments. With a range of 2,200 kilometers and the ability to carry a sizable cargo, the T-60S project was ultimately shelved with the fall of the Soviet Union. It was faster and lighter than the Tu-22M3M. Its cancellation was partly a result of technical difficulties and hazardous design decisions, which made the Tu-22M3 variation and the more dependable Su-34 fullback model more appealing. The T-4 idea, an attempted Soviet reply to the North American XB-70 Valkyrie bomber design, never advanced past the prototype stage but had its first flight on September 21, 1964, is where the Sukhoi T-60s project originated. With a combat range of 2,200 kilometers, the T-60S is thought to be capable of transporting a payload as heavy as 20,000 TLRQ. The T-60S prototype was supposed to go through flight testing in 1996 and be put into service by the Russian Air Force in 2003, even though the project was abandoned. However, these ambitions came to a stop with the fall of the Soviet Union, and in the early 1990s, the project was almost completely canceled. There have been suggestions that the T-60S project might be revived, as reported by the National Interest. It appears that Sukhoi engineers had difficulty putting some of the T-60S's novel design choices into practice, such as the contentious wing construction modifications. The T-60S is estimated to be 40 meters long, 24 to 37 meters wide when folded, and 10 meters tall based on the specs. The greatest height at which the T-60S is intended to fly is 20,000 meters. In terms of velocity, the T-60S can reach a maximum speed of Mach 2.04 and a cruising speed of Mach 2. The bomber weighs 32 tons empty and can carry up to 85 tons at takeoff. But the T-60S's formidable fighting skills could not justify the dangers associated with more unusual design decisions. Suggested by the Kremlin, the Su-34 fighter bomber was a more secure option. 120 Su-34s are in use at the moment, and further rounds of upgrade packages are scheduled for the upcoming years. In the same vein, the outdated Tu-22M3M bombers will receive an upgrade to enable them to fire Mach 10 KH-47 Kinjal hypersonic missiles.